Excuse me, drop this.
Oh, sorry about that. I didn't even notice.
It's okay. Just stay alert next time to make sure you avoid littering as much as possible.
I don't mean to be rude, but what effect would a single bag have on the environment? It's not hurting anybody as far as I can see.
Well, that's just the problem. Not everybody understands the true impact littering has on the environment. Look around closely. You will notice trash that should have never met your eye.
There's so much.
These rivers connect people. A universal continuity between everyone. To destroy it, it would be a shame. It's not even just the garbage either. Water is being contaminated by toxins such as arsenic, benzene, and mercury. Let me ask you, would you go near water with toxins that could poison you?
Absolutely not. I've taken enough chemistry to know what happens when arsenic and mercury get where they shouldn't.
Anyways, it was nice talking to you. Make sure to keep all this in mind and more for the better interest of our environment and us.
All right, see ya.
What can I do to help?
Good afternoon. I'm Morgan Akins Hinkle coming at you live from ABC News Chicago. Today we have a special story about the Mississippi River and its horrible pollution problem, causing countless environmental issues that are detrimental to life on the river. From the banks of the Mississippi River, we have a special guest who has come to explain the impact of pollution on the river, an environmental activist who has made it their life's goal to help reverse the flow of pollution plaguing America's river.
Thank you, Morgan. As you can see, I'm here reporting from the river, and I'm excited to share with you all of the results and research that I have come to from my time working on our river crisis. While the health of our rivers may seem irrelevant, slipping past our busy minds time after time, it is actually hardly the case. As time goes on, our oceans, our global unification, get more and more polluted, harming wildlife and marine life, destroying environments, and exterminating entire species. You might ask, how does this affect humans? Well, disruptions in our food chain and contamination of the water we drink can be traced back to the presence of metals and chemicals such as oil, mercury, lead, and pesticides. As a universal solvent, water will absorb and combine with many objects it is exposed to, and that includes the trash and different chemicals, oils that it may be exposed to in the river. The deadly mix of plastic, trash, and sewage that snakes through our rivers can be fixed, but to do so, we need your help. Here with me today is one of my crewmates who's going to talk to you about common courtesy and things that you can do to make the rivers safe.
Good morning, and thank you for having me. Today, I briefly want to explain what you, your friends, and your family can be doing to keep our rivers and ultimately our environments clean. First, please be mindful of what you leave at our rivers or even on the streets, for anything can find its way back to the canals via wind or sewage system. Other tips and tricks may include picking up your pet's waste, chemicals and leaves to stay away from drains, and using mulch and vegetation to prevent soil runoff. Don't litter and make sure to call out anyone else you see doing so.
Well, thank you for this enlightening information. I learned quite a bit, and I'm sure the people watching at home learned something about the river as well. I'm Morgan Akins Hinkle from ABC News.